A peatland is an ecosystem where high water tables have prevented the decomposition of plant material as it dies and falls to the ground, to the point where that plant material has built up and formed giant mats of organic matter that are resistant to decomposition and support the really unique plant communities.
I think most of the times when we think of wetlands, generally, right, they're always usually like gross and smelly and kind of stuff decaying and percolating up through the groundwater. But that's not the case. Peatlands smell really good.
Peatlands are important ecosystems in a lot of ways. First off, they support plant and animal communities. So they're important in terms of biodiversity. They're important in terms of water storage and water quality. Peatlands are kind of big water sinks and for some places, water filters. But the ecosystem function we most often talk about with peatlands, why people are really starting to care the most about them, is that they are enormous carbon sinks. So while peatlands only cover 3% of the Earth's surface, they probably store on the order of 30% of the world's soil organic carbon. That number is comparable to the amount of carbon that's stored in global forests. And that carbon storage is very long-term carbon storage. Peat can persist for thousands to tens of thousands of years.
Minnesota has more peatlands than any state in the lower 48. They store a lot of carbon in the peat. But you know, they hold a lot of water, so they help with downstream water quality and, you know, reducing flooding downstream.
People have the idea that peatlands, because they're wet, that they're causing flooding. But actually they're doing the exact opposite. They're helping to capture and store and filter that water and hold it back. So you always have water in the bog, even during a drought. And they help to moderate flow in lakes and streams. So I think that it's not a coincidence that we have clean, healthy wild rice lakes, for example, across the same landscapes that we have intact peatlands.
All wetlands have been sort of underdogs for a long time. And you know, I think there's just a perception of this being sort of wasteland. It is changing, I think, a little bit. You know, there's a lot of good wildlife viewing opportunities, owls and raptors, and a lot of interesting plants, fun to walk around in. Some of the plants are specialized in ways of getting nutrients. So you have like the pitcher plant and the sundew are these carnivorous plants, kind of unique.
I think that they're beautiful, a wilderness that we have yet to explore in some ways.
We think about what we need from peatlands, but what do they need from us? I think first, a greater acknowledgement of their value as intact natural ecosystems, a greater appreciation of their biodiversity is important. Above and beyond valuing them for their ecosystem function, valuing them for these unique plant communities, and just how beautiful they are is important.